everyone, welcome back to Design News. In today's Design News, we're looking at a revolutionary new Figma update, a brand new UX design course, which is free, ability to convert Figma designs into Webflow websites, and much, much more. So without further ado, let's just get started with Design News. If you aren't subscribed to Design News, make sure you click on that subscribe button and also make sure you click on that bell icon so that you get updated whenever I post a new episode. And subscribing is free, so go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Now, last week, I told you guys about the Big Sur update for Mac. Somebody has actually made an entire case study or the lessons that you can learn as a UX designer from Mac OS Big Sur. Read through it and learn a little more about the intricate details that go into designing such systems. A new UX tool is out there. It's called the UX Toolset. As UX designers, you must be learning UX design processes. To make that process easier, there is now a toolkit. These are basically fully customized wireframes, flowcharts, user journeys, and much, much more for both Figma as well as Sketch. Not only that, it also has UI components so that you can kickstart your UI design from your UX processes. So if you are creating a flowchart, if you want to make it clean, if you want to make it organized, this is the tool set to use. Now, Figma is a great tool, but not everybody uses Figma. Some of you guys might be using XD, Sketch, and other such tools, but you want the collaboration features inside all the other tools as well. Well, now there is a tool that enables that. Pixtar, collaborate and review with your design team or with other stakeholders, websites, graphic design, and much, much more. A great feature is that you can organize all your screens and everybody can then look at all those screens, collaborate on it, comment on it, and even give you proper visual feedback. What should be placed here, what shouldn't be placed through an application on the web, so you don't even have to download anything. Figma now has some really cool new features which I'm super excited about. The first feature is related to auto layout. Now you have custom padding, so you can give 20 pixels at the bottom, 30 pixels at the top, much like what you see in Webflow and other web design tools. That kind of feature is now also in Figma. You also have some new content related capabilities. You can make an element hug another element. So if you have text inside a card, you can make the text hug the card or the card hug the text. Or you can even give even spacing on all sides of two or multiple elements. That allows you to create some amazing responsive design elements. You can create complete prototypes for websites and much, much more with Figma now because of these capabilities. Figma, well, you are winning right now, okay? I agree. Talking about responsive design, this has been my dream for a lot of time. Converting designs to Webflow. I really wanted to create a video. I haven't been able to do it. But with System Flow, for a very small fee, you can convert your Figma designs into Webflow designs. Yes, you heard that right. Now you don't need to learn Webflow separately or learn any other web design tool separately. How does it work? Well, it's very simple. It has all the components in Figma laid out. So you use their UI toolkit, you create a user interface using that kit, you add certain settings, and based on that, you can just copy that kit from Figma to Webflow. Essentially, you are using the same components you'd use on Webflow on Figma right now, and it is very seamless. At least that is what they market it as. If you guys want me to create a video on that, make sure you comment down below and say, "We want Figma to Webflow." I understand, I will create a new tutorial on that. Now there are two brand new ways on how you can learn to design. The first way is UI Coach. I always emphasize this to everyone. You have to practice so that you can improve in design. How do you practice without getting actual clients? UI Coach allows you to create mock clients so that there are requirements that clients would generally give you, but this is not real. At the same time, you can also analyze yourself, you can practice on yourself and create new projects for your portfolios through this tool. Go check it out. It's free of cost, so there's no harm trying it out. The next one is actually a platform to learn how to design. They have a very interesting and almost like a game form of learning how to UX. There are tests, there are levels that you cross and you reach a certain level, and it is very, very interactive. I wish this existed when I was learning how to design. It would be so much fun. They are following a method called micro teaching. There are thousands of lessons, but each lesson is short. You don't have to sit through a boring lecture anymore. UX Excel allows you to excel in design with short courses, short bite-sized videos, and other sort of tests. They also have something called weekly challenges. So every week they challenge you to something new, and you can display your cool designs or what you have achieved on your own on their platform. So that was it for today's design news. If you did like the video, make sure you press the thumbs up if you liked today's video, because that helps support the channel, it motivates me to create more videos, and it keeps me going. Thank you guys for all the support to this series. I'll see you next time, same place, same time, twice a week. Till then, God bless.